was just a place down, but I left them here two nights this week. And then I got here the other morning, his car was here. I said, wait a minute, I left you here last night, and now you're here this morning. Praise the Lord. I was feeling some kind of way about that, but that is the dedication that this young man has. He has been studying, and we just appreciate again his life and his wife and the mother. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord, mother. Amen. We're grateful. We love people, and we especially love people who love God, because there is strength in that. So without any further ado, you all know this young man. He's an ex-Marine, and also just celebrated with a blessing for us on Veterans Day. Great singer. He sung. Oh, yeah, he sung. He prayed and he sang. That wasn't scripture. So. But he's been very active here, and again, we're so grateful for this. And without any further ado, I don't know if they're going to do a duet or a motet, but I turn you over to the hands. I see a whole setup down here. I came in late last night. I said, now, wait a minute. I don't need props today. I normally have props, but I guess he ready to deal. Amen. So let us say amen. For Minister Jon Colbert.
Oh, safe in his arms.
Hallelujah.
Oh, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, Father. Lord God, thank you for this opportunity right now, Lord God. Thank you for the chance to get up here, Lord, and present the word that you have spoken to my heart, Lord God.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord God, I hope that I give it to your people in the proper context that you've given it to me, Lord. That it may reach further ground, Lord. That your people may grow.
Hallelujah.
And that you may get in the increase, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. In your Son Jesus' name, I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. First of all, I'd like to just thank Pastor Daniels and First Lady for just allowing me to be able to present what God laid on my heart. I'd like to thank my church members to come out this morning and support me. I'd like to thank my family for coming out to support your son, your brother, your uncle, your cousin, father, friend. I'm just glad for all of you to be out here with me this morning. I thank God for my lovely wife to come out and support me. Thank you for all you do. Thank you for your support. Let me be able to serve the Lord and not have to worry where her husband is when he's at the church late at night.
Amen.
You know, that's a good thing. I just like to thank you for your support. Even when we were dating, I told you, I think I've been called to minister, and you didn't run, so I just... I thank you for that, and I thank you for giving me a son that I am well pleased in with.
Amen.
And without any further delay, I want to ask you to open your Bibles and turn to Luke, the 15th chapter. It's a familiar scripture. We're going to start with the 11th verse. Amen. 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 When you have it, you can say amen. Please say amen. Luke, the 15th chapter, 11th verse. And amen. Amen. The word says, Jesus continued. He said, there's a man who had two sons. The younger son said to his father, Father, give me my share of the estate. So he divided his property between them. Not long after that, the younger son got together all he had, set off for a distant country, and there squandered his wealth in wild living. After he had spent everything, there was a severe famine in the whole country, and he began to be in need. So he went and hired himself out to a citizen of that country who sent him to the fields to feed pigs. He longed to fill his stomach with the pods that the pigs were eating, but no one gave him anything. This is the best part. But when he came to his senses, he said, how many of my father's hired servants have food to spare? And here I am, starving to death. I will set out and go back to my father and say to him, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I am no longer worthy to be called your son. Make me like one of your hired servants. So he got up and he went to his father. Amen. You may be seated. Amen. Amen. How many of you know that God allows us to go through things to get us to a position where we can be used?
Yes, yes,
amen.
Yes, yes, yes.
For His purpose. Amen.
Yes, yes.
In this familiar passage, we see a younger son go ask his father, said, "Father, I want you to give me my inheritance now." What he didn't understand was, in reality, he was slapping his father in his face.
Yes, sir.
He was telling his father, "I wish you were dead. But since you've taken so long to die, give me what is mine now while you are still living." And in this case, it's a bittersweet moment for a father, because one, you don't want to send your son or see your children go. But two, as a father, you want to see your son stand on his feet and make good decisions and go out and venture into the world.
Hallelujah.
So it's a bittersweet moment for him. And I see the father, he's like reasoning with himself and saying, should I withhold this and have my son resent me? Or should I go ahead and give in and let him go and explore the world and do the things that he need to do? So the father goes with the latter and devises his earnings and gives it to his son and let him go out and explore the world. But the son has a hidden agenda. He don't just want to explore the world. He wants to party like he's a rock star. He wants to get out and he wants to be what he sees on TV. He want to be love and hip hop. He want to be the next American Idol. So, you know, you gotta ask yourself, you know, what you ask for it for.
Yeah.
You know, that's what you gotta ask yourself. What you ask for it for. You know. So, the word said, despite the son being raised in a religious home, he took all he had. He said, cashed in his father's credit, took all he had, left his father's land, went to a new country. He lost everything.
Glory.
Everything.
Glory.
Despite being raised in a religious home, he went out and he wanted to party. He wanted to see what it was that forbidden thing that his father was trying to shield him from. And like that son, many of us today are do the same thing. We try to we can't wait to get out of our parents' house so that we can go out there and see the world and do big things. And sometimes it happens, we be just like that young son where we fall back into losing everything that we have. And we find ourselves wallowing with the pigs.
Say it, sir. Say it.
The prophet Haggai in the 5th chapter told us that we have to be careful of our thoughts and our ways. Because times we sow so much, but we reap so little. You know, and this was the case of the young son. He got out there, and just because he had a pocket full of money, he thought he could live up the world. But he didn't think about replenishing, because that little pocket full of money that he had was soon dwindling and running out. And then he came, he opened his eyes and said, "Oh Lord, I need to go hire myself out." And it reminded me of something that my Aunt Mickey used to always tell me. She said, "John, if you don't have within you that which is above you,
glory,
you will soon be succumbed to that which is about you."
That's good.
And that was this young man's plot.
Yeah.
He got so rich into doing what he wanted to do and partying and not giving thought to his upbringing that his father gave him. And soon he would succumb to the world that was around him.
Glory.
You know, but at that time, you know, you gotta find yourself falling back onto those things that you remember. You gotta remember to trust in the Lord with all your heart and seek God, not your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge God, and He shall direct your path. Amen. And although the sons hit his motors, led him into mayhem, fortunately, the pressures of the world got him into the best position of power that he could ever be in. Amen, amen.
Hallelujah.
The scripture said that at this point, he got so low that he desired to eat the slop, the same slop that he was giving the pigs. And how many of you know that when you have a taste for rightful food, you can't go back to any old slop? You know. So I tell, don't feed me no slop. You know, I know the word, and I have the taste for rightful food. So you can't feed me no slop.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. So this pressure that the son fall under, I broke it down into acronym: pressure, P, procrastination.
All right.
These are things that keeps us from keeps us under the pressure of the world. Our procrastination, that we procrastinate. We put off to today what we can do today for tomorrow. Glory. We procrastinate. And when we procrastinate, we dig ourselves in a deeper ditch and deficit. Whether it's in debt, say, "I can pay this bill now, but I'm gonna pay it tomorrow." I'm procrastinate on this. If it's our time, we could do something. We procrastinate but what that procrastination does, it beats us down physically and mentally.
Yeah,
because now we're behind the power curve, and we're constantly in a fight to try to catch upstream. So we peeve procrastination. R is our response. Our response to things that come into our life, whether it be someone cut you off on the road, your response. Someone says a bad word to you, your response. Someone that gives you a face that you don't understand. They might not even be looking at you. They might be thinking about something that's going on. But your response to them can and add pressure to your life.
Yes, Lord.
Our expectations.
Yes.
Our expectations. Sometimes we expect too high. We set our expectations too high, and we can't achieve them. Sometimes we set our expectations too low, and we don't put enough effort into trying to achieve them. And sometimes we don't have any expectations at all. And that's the worst kind of expectation, because that's when we get surprised. And then we fall behind that power curve. And then the pressures of life beat us down. Our surroundings, that first S, our surroundings, the things and people that we surround ourselves with, the places we go, those things hinder us from reaching our destination.
Yes, sir.
Those friends beat us down.
Yes, they do.
You know, yeah. Hey, let's go smoke a joint. Hey, let's go to the club. Let's drink ourselves stupid. Let's go have a good time. Let's go party like a rock star. Yeah. Our surroundings.
Glory.
The other S, our selfishness.
Yeah.
Our own. We isolate ourselves from God and others with our own selfish desires.
Yes.
Praise the Lord.
Blessing.
The U. Our unforgiveness.
You better talk up in here.
Yes.
We walk around with unforgiveness in our heart.
Yes.
Someone said it's like drinking poison and hoping that the person that you hate dies from it.
Wow.
Because your unforgiveness, we hold onto grudges and offenses that hinder us from moving forward. And that creates unnecessary pressure.
Yes.
My God.
When most of the time, those people, they don't even know that they offend us. The R, the second R, is rebellion. It's just plain. We know what's right. We just rebel against it.
Yes, sir.
We've been raised in the church. We've been in the church all our lives, but we just rebel against it. And that final E is our excuses.
My God.
Yeah, yeah.
We have an excuse for everything.
Yes, we do.
We have an excuse. I gotta get myself right before I get back to church. I gotta go cut off this one tie. You know. It's just this one thing I gotta do.
Glory.
And excuses.
All these things.
Procrastination.
Yes, sir.
Our response, our expectations, our surroundings, our selfishness, our unforgiveness, our rebellion, and our excuses. Those create our pressures of life. But regardless of what causes the pressure in our life, the good thing is, like that son, we have a chance to come to our senses.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. It just think about it. Why do we lack for anything? It's like the song said, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures." What that means is he takes me to a place where I can rest. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still water. Even though the storms of life are raging, the word said, Jesus said, "Peace, be still." And he leads you beside the still waters. He restores your soul.
Yeah.
And he leads you in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. So the song said, it's for my good, but it's for his glory. He leads us in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake.
Hallelujah.
And that's the reason that we go through things that we go through, so that God can get the glory out of the things that we do. He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I shall fear no evil. But you got to understand, it's called the valley of the shadow of death. The reason it's the shadow of death, because God is with you. The word said that I am the light, the truth. I am the way, the truth, and the light. So it's the only thing that can cast a shadow is light. So that's why it's called the valley of the shadow of death. That's why you should fear no evil.
Yes, sir.
It said,
amen.
Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. The rod corrects you. That's what it said. Spare the rod, you spoil the child. The rod corrects you, and the staff guides you.
Hallelujah.
Just like a band conductor. You see him, he has his staff. His staff guides the band. Just like a shepherd, his staff guides his sheep.
Yeah.
But what it is, it said, you find comfort in it. And knowing, because that same rod and staff that guides and corrects you, that same rod and staff, it protects you and wards off the dangers of this world.
Yeah. Right.
All right.
Now, the rewards of coming to your senses.
All right.
These are the rewards. It said that when the son came to his senses, he went back to his father. And when he goes back to his father, he gets restored.
Glory.
The father, he showers him with kisses.
Yeah.
The father, he gives him a robe.
Yeah.
Hallelujah, Father. Thank you, Lord. Said his father gives him a robe.
Yeah. Work it.
Amen.
All right.
Amen. How many of you know the robe, it represents the blood of Jesus?
Yeah.
Because the robe covers you.
Yeah.
Amen. And then he said, he gives him a ring of gold. That's the ring of gold. Yeah, he gives him the ring of gold.
All right now.
Amen. He gives him a ring of gold. This ring of gold represents his marriage to the backslider.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And then he said, he killed the fatted calf for me. And right after, what it said, he killed the fatted calf. He prepared a table before him in the presence of his enemy. But so many of us think that our adversaries and our enemies are the people and the forces outside of us.
You better talk, sir.
But the only true enemy that we have is yourself.
Yeah.
Because the Bible said life and death lies in the power of your own tongue. You have to confess with your mouth and believe in your heart that the Son, Jesus Christ, is Lord. And that's the only way that you can be saved. So he prepares a table before you in the presence of your enemy. This is your only enemy right here. The man that you look, the person that you look at in the mirror, that's the only one that can hinder you from getting into heaven.
Amen.
That can hinder you from reaching your heavenly Father. Amen. Hallelujah, Father.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for your word, Lord.
Amen.
The reason why the Father goes through all these changes for his son, the verse 24 says, "This is my son." He was dead and is alive again.
Praise the Lord.
He was lost.
Oh, yeah.
And now is found.
Yeah.
And they began to be merry. I mean, they truly parted like a rock star.
Yeah.
Amen. The reason why is because when you are in sin and disconnected from the Father, there you are dead.
Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
But when you come to your senses,
come on now.
Thank you, Lord. And you return to the Father. He says,
surely
goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. And you shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Today, I want to offer you the chance to be restored.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. This is your opportunity. If you are procrastinating, if you want to change your response, if you want to get the right expectation with God, you want to change your surroundings, you want to stop being selfish, stop harboring unforgiveness, stop being a rebellion, and plain old just stop making excuses. This is your chance. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
Amen for Minister John and the Word of God.